It's baby mania in Hollywood. Congrats to these new celeb parents, Emma Roberts, Josh Brolin, and Nick Cannon, all recently welcomed new additions to their family. And because we expect nothing less from celebrities, all of their children have uncommon names. Okay, so there's Emma Roberts and her partner named their baby boy Rhodes, spelled like Rhodes Scholar. Do you like that one, Brandon?
Yeah, it's all right.
Ooh, Erica liked it.
It's all right.
I thought it was cute. It gives you someplace to go with it.
Brandon's not feeling it. Okay, what about Josh Brolin and his wife? They welcomed their second child together named Chapel Grace, Jeff.
I like that. I like Rhodes and I like Chapel Grace. I like both of those.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah. Finally, and I'm going to give this one to the harsh critic, Mr. Brandon London. Nick Cannon and his girlfriend named their second child together Powerful Queen Cannon. What do you think of that, B-Lun?
I can see that because I see him holding her and like looking at her and telling her, you are a powerful queen.
Aww.
You know, that's affirmations to your daughter. I'll do that. I would do that to my daughter. So I'm A-okay with that. And I think that was great, Nick Cannon. Great name.
Do you think you need a nickname if your name's Powerful Queen? Am I being disrespectful here? Or do you think that's kind of weird to be like, you know, you're at Starbucks and you're a powerful queen, and everyone's like, That's my coffee.
I would raise my hand. I think there is, I love the sentiment. I think that it gives her, you know, they announced her to the world. I mean, that is everything. But the problem with naming your child an adjective is that it's so commonly used. So I would be concerned that every time you hear the word powerful anywhere, you're like, on alert.
Always on edge.
Yeah, like if
not
somebody talking
but you
to me.
Are.
I'm looking around like who's talking to me?
But Brandon, on the flip side, listen, I love the idea of affirmation. There's nothing more than I want is to instill confidence and affirmation in my children. But are you also setting them up for failure if like their name is, you know, if you have to live up to Powerful Queen? Are you setting them up for entitlement? I'm not saying that's the case, just something to think about.
Yes, you have to be successful, but the pressure is not on the kid with the unique name. The pressure is on the kid that doesn't have the unique name, because that means your parents thought you were going to be average.
No.
They give the unique name to the kid that they think is going to grow up to be something in life.
That average name could be a family name.
How about like A Boy Named Sue? That whole song? You ever hear that song?
No.
A Boy Named Sue by Johnny Cash?
No.
It talks about like his name Sue, right? So it's like he's weaker, but he ends up being powerful.
I love that.
You know what I mean?
Very
so it's like,
cool.
Brandon, you kind of, I hope that's the meaning of that song. but that you just mentioned like your name. Sometimes if you get that name, like say you're a boy named Sue, just as that example, you fight and say, I'm not going to be that guy that my father thought I was, right? But then if you get Powerful Queen, it could work in the opposite way, right?
But Jeff,
final thought, Brandon.
My middle name was Jamie. I was a guy. My middle name is Jamie, and I went by Jamie for a little bit. And I changed that to Brandon because I thought at the time it would be a little bit more manly. So there was pressure on going by Jamie. So imagine what having Sue. Imagine that pressure.
I like.
Wait, did you just say you changed your name?
Yes. So is your name Jamie or Brandon? What's your name?
My middle name is Jamie. My middle name is Jamie. My family calls me Jamie.
Wavy James.
Wavy. Got it.
2020 has been a challenging year, to say the least.
We want to thank you for spending your time with us. From all of us here at DBL,
we want to wish you a happy holiday
and a healthy new year.